the time of recording this video, there's a lot of hype around Team of the Season. We do only have the English Football League and the community teams as of right now, but since they've been released, everyone is wanting to pack them and everyone is wanting to own these players. This has made it incredibly hard to trade with. You'll put bids in for some of these Team of the Season players and instantly be outbidded. And by the time you do finally get one of these players, unfortunately, because there was way too much hype around them, it has increased their price massively, so when you do go on to sell them, you're only making a couple hundred or even a couple thousand coins. For the time it took for you to get that player, it just isn't worth it. Now, once more teams do get released, it will become worth it for you to trade with some of these Team of the Season players. As of right now, it just isn't worth it. But we can use them in a different way. Before I do get into the video, if you do enjoy the content here, then make sure you hit that subscribe button and that notification bell. Doing this, make sure that you'll be up to date with all FIFA Ultimate Team news and the latest trader methods. If you want to take things a step further, you can also go into the description down below and now you'll find a link to Discord. This has been something that a lot of people have been requesting. We finally got it sorted. And over there, I will also be posting some of the trades that I'm able to do, and I'll be able to post it a lot quicker over there than actually putting together a video. Link to the Discord can be found in the description down below. But getting back into the video, I've always liked trading with Team of the Week players. Building up to Team of the Season, I have been investing a lot of coins into these types of deals, holding them and watching them go up in value. To this day, I'm still holding some of these players. But now, more than ever, it is a great time for you to be trading with some of these Team of the Week players. As the EFL and the Community Team of the Season was released last week, there's been a lot of hype and a lot of attention going into these specific special cards. And even though I would love to give you a trading method of how to trade with some of these Team of the Season players, right now there's just way too much attention. But because there's been way too much attention going to one specific type of special card, we can actually look at the other types of special cards. And this is where Team of the Week players do come in. Because everyone's looking at Team of the Season, we can happily trade with Team of the Week players, get them way below market value and sell them for a very decent amount of profit. We're not just talking about a couple hundred coins, we're talking about a couple thousand coins. And depending on what type of special card you're looking at, you can get one of these every minute. Now in this video, I will be solely focusing on Team of the Week players. This is what I had luck with the time that I was trading. But you can do this with any other type of special card within the game. And there's a couple ways that you can do this. The first way and the way that I've had the most success is just by searching the whole market for Team of the Week players. This does help if you have a second account. So when I was trading, I was playing on my console on my Xbox Series X, and this was the Foot Fanatic account. But I also had a second account, and this was just an account with nothing really on it, but I was able to use it on the web app so I can use the transfer market and search specific types of players and their prices. If you don't have this, it's not a major issue, it just means it's going to take a lot more time. You have to add players to your watch list, back out, go into the transfer market, search that specific player, find their lowest buy now just to go back to the watch list and bid accordingly. It's a lot longer, whereas just having a second account makes life so much easier. Type names in while still looking at that specific player on your console. So what I'm doing with this is just going over to the transfer market, selecting Team of the Week players and just searching. I will then hold right and just go across page after page. Eventually you'll come across a player that has a bid on. This is when I quickly take the time to go to my second account, look on the web app, look on the transfer market, find that player and find their lowest buy now. And depending on that player's buy now, this is when I put a bid in. This has been a great method for me over the past couple of days. Because everyone's looking at Team of the Seasons, I can focus on these and put very low bids in and very successfully get these players. To list these players on the transfer market by a couple thousand coins and for them to sell within the first hour. You do come across some players that have ridiculous bids on them, something that exceeds so much higher than what their lowest buy now is. This is just a few players which I believe is just trying to transfer coins from one account to another. So be careful when looking at these types of players, but as long as you're trying to find their lowest buy now, you'll realize that that player doesn't sell for that, and then just ignore it and move on to the next. To help get some of these players, I am using the methods that I always use when bidding on players. I have done a specific video of how to get more deals in FIFA Ultimate Team. If you want to see that, there is a link in the description down below, as well as there'll be a card on screen right now which you can click and it'll take you directly to that video. But the biggest tip I can give you here is trying to frustrate whoever you're bidding against. I would add players to the watch list, wait until they get anywhere between 27 to 35 seconds, and I'll place my first bid. If I get outbidded, I'm waiting for that to go all the way down to 3 to 5 seconds before I put a bid in again. And I'll keep this going. Eventually, you'll get to a point where you either win the deal or that player exceeds the bid amount that you're willing to pay, where you will no longer be making profit. You'll just be making a loss. As soon as that happens, remove that player. Move on to the next one. With this method, I am just focusing on a few players. Add them to the watch list, bid on them. If I win them, great, I'll list them immediately. If I don't win them and they all get outbidded, I'll just go back through to the transfer market, find another couple players and do the same thing again. I don't want to get overwhelmed with more than 5 players in my watch list and trying to bid on all 5 at the exact same time whilst they're all going down to the last couple of seconds. It just becomes way too much, so I recommend limiting the amount of players that you're adding to your watch list. The other way that you can do this is searching for specific types of players. This is something that we actually did when first investing in Team of the Week players. We looked at the current Team of the Week, tried to find those that are very cheap that are in the Premier League, Serie A, Ligue 1, Bundesliga or La Liga. We managed to get quite a few of these for way less than the lowest buy now. Well, we're doing the exact same thing here, except now we're instantly selling them on for trading rather than investing. Because no one's really looking at Team of the Week players as an option to bid, we're able to get these a lot lower than what we were able to get them before. Whoever the specific player is that you're looking at, make sure that you know their lowest buy now. Take a couple thousand coins away and then this is your maximum bid price. Set that as your maximum bid, search for players, add them all to your watch list, and yet again, I wait until they get down to the last 30 seconds and I'll just put a bid in. Most of the time, you will be able to win these players. And depending on the price of the player that you're looking at, will also depend on your profit. Those that go for anywhere between 10 to 20k, you're probably only going to be making a couple thousand coins. But those that are a lot higher, you could be making a lot more. And it is recommended that you do stick to this week's Team of the Week. This is just because you'll be able to find more of those types of players on the market at the same time. And this is simply because they're still in packs. For the previous Team of the Weeks, they've been taken out of packs, so no one's able to get them. So therefore, they're a lot rarer on the market, and you're probably not going to be able to find as many when going through under the bid amount that you're willing to pay. Just like the previous method when adding players to the watch list, limit how many players you're looking at the exact same time. With this one, you'll have many cards within your watch list, but it shouldn't exceed more than 5 different versions of a specific type of player. So when I was trading going through this, I looked at Brennan Johnson, Javier Hernandez, and I also traded with Omlin. These were the only players that I looked at the exact same time. But I would have 5-6 of each of these players within my watch list, making it worth my time to wait for these players to go down to the last 30 seconds and then put in a bid in. But it was never a situation where I was overwhelmed, where there was 3 or 4 players expiring at the exact same time and I had to keep up with bidding on each and every one of them. The third and final way that you can go through this is by looking at the buy nows. For some of these Team of the Week players, when searching their buy now, you'll find out that some of them have a much lower buy now compared to the rest on the market. If you find this, buy the lowest buy now, relist it, undercutting the next cheapest, but still enough for you to make profit. I wouldn't solely just focus on just this specific one, but whilst you're trying to find the cheapest buy nows with the players when going through the transfer market, or whether or not you're searching a specific player, this is a good time for you just to keep an eye out. Yet again, because everyone's focus is on Team of the Season, it means when Team of the Week players or any other special card gets listed, and it's way below the rest of the market, no one's actually searching these players up. Everyone's focused on Team of the Season that these deals are getting missed. So some of these players are able to go down to the last 10-15 minutes before anyone actually notices that that player's price is a lot lower compared to the other types of players that are on the market. Buying this will give you a few extra 100 coins or an extra few thousand coins depending on the deal. You just want to keep a lookout for these. These are the 3 methods that I'm looking at whilst trading during Team of the Season. I've been spending a lot of time trying to find a Team of the Season trader method, but as of right now, because there's a limited amount of players, it's just not a good idea. I'm spending way too much time just to try and find one deal, only for that one deal just to give me a few hundred or even a few thousand coins. And I'm putting up a lot more coins than what I'm expecting. With Team of the Week and other special cards, I'm putting a lot less coins up, but I'm able to make a bigger profit. So for now, the numbers make sense for you to stick to other special cards rather than trade them with Team of the Season. You can, of course, pair this up with the other things that we've been talking about on the channel in the last couple of videos. This is bulk bidding on cheap rare gold players for 600 650 coins and selling them for 850 all the way up to 1800. This method is still working. You're not able to get as many deals, but once the next Team of the Season is released, this will be a working and very functional method yet again. And of course, we do also have the silver trader method. The silver trader method takes next to no coins. So if you don't have enough coins to bulk bid on rare gold players or enough coins for you to go for team of the week players, then this is the method for you. All of these are working, and these methods are the only ones I'm using right now whilst I wait for a good team of the season method to actually be available. But anyway guys, this is what I recommend for trading as of right now. If you do want to talk more in depth, then make sure you head into the description down below where you can find a link to Discord. Head over there and you'll find all the latest tips and tricks and what I'm actually currently trading with and investing with. But anyway guys, thank you very much for watching. I hope you guys did enjoy. If you did enjoy, don't forget to leave a like and subscribe. But for now, I'm going. So see ya.